it's Melissa. In this video, we are going to go start to finish on printing our first print on our Epson V1070. So this is going to be a UV print on our UV printer. Now, I will tell you, this was my first print. This was my second print. I worked up to this. So this one actually is a print that just has white and then the color. This one, I added a third layer of varnish, and this is actually a DTF, a UV DTF. So I did three different things here, but this is what we're gonna do. We're gonna basically take like a scrap piece of something that we don't care about, and we're gonna print. Now, the tutorial that I'm gonna show you is going to be printing on this cutting board. What can you see? It is not perfect. And I want you to know that that is what is going to happen with your first print. So this one is pretty good. Hopefully you can see that. See that glare there? That's the varnish. It's beautiful, isn't it? But I didn't get it totally centered. That's okay. That is what you should expect with your first print. So don't go taking an order and then you're going to do it. No, you're not. You're going to practice first. We're going to work up to something like this. A full UV print like that. But for right now, we are going to do our first print start to finish on wood, directly onto wood, and I'll meet you over in Epson Edge Print.
Okay, so we are going to do our first print, and what we need to do first when we have Epson Edge Print open is click add, and that is going to allow us to add a job. So this is the job that I am going to do right here, North Pole Cookie. So I'm just going to click open, and it's going to bring it into the job list, and then it's going to put it over here as a little preview. So this is representing the platen. It's, as you can see, the status it's adding, so just be patient. Now, it's very large, so the job info tells you the exact size. So as you can see, this is 66 inches. I am not trying to print a poster, so we are going to need to make this smaller. So what we're going to do is go to layout and adjust the size of my print. So I'm just, I know that my what I'm printing on is 8x10. It's 8 inches wide by 10 inches. So I am going to do this like about 6x8. Okay. And actually I need to rotate it. So what I'm going to do is rotate clockwise. And now I'm going to adjust this to 6x8. So I need it to be about 6 inches wide, well, it turns out that it's about 7. So I have my substrate, which is a cutting board right now, is 8x10. Okay. So that is going up here. All right. So I want to try to center this a little bit. So what I need to do is I need to increase the horizontal distance from the side, which now it's 1 inch. It's about right. I'm going to do it at 1.25. Just to make it, okay. And then I'm going to do the same thing vertically. We need it to be closer to 10. Put that at 2 and see what happens. That's too much. About the same. I'll have other videos on how to make templates so that you can exact center, but for this one, I really just want you to see the basics of the software, okay? All right, so now that we have it in position, let's go back and do some basic settings, okay? So media material, we're just gonna use general for right now, and the number and layer of order. So if you only wanna print color, this is the layer, this is what you can keep it on. But if you want to print your color with white underneath, because you have a dark substrate, then you need to do a double layer. White first to give you a base and block out basically the color of the substrate, and then color on top. If you want to add a glossy or matte finish of varnish, you need to do a triple layer. So that would be white, color, varnish. So you have to decide what you want to do. Okay, so in this case, I'm just going to click white, color, and then varnish, a three layer. And the reason I'm doing that is because I want to show you a few things, okay? So we don't need to switch anything there. This is asking us, what resolution do you want to use? I'm actually going to increase all of these to I'm going to increase all of them. Now, what you see here is your first layer of white is there. Your second layer of color is there. Your third layer of varnish is not there. Like, what do you do? Why is it a question mark? Don't worry. Select the third layer varnish, go to layer settings, and then down here where it says creating method, just click image, and then you're going to get your image in varnish, okay? So that's all you need to do for that. I don't know why white and color come up, but varnish doesn't, but that's how you're going to fix that. So you've got all of these here. Everything is good. We are not going to change anything with density right now. We are not going to change anything else. We are only going to do those basic things. And now what we are going to do is we are going to click print. You need to be on the top layer, the full job, in order to be able to click print. If you are only on one of the individual layers, it's not going to allow you to do that, okay? So click print. Now it's not going to start printing. You need to go over to your printer, okay, to do that. Okay, so what you can see is the file name is here. The media height, we did that in a previous video. So if you haven't already adjusted the media height, I would go through that video and I will link to that in the description below, okay? And then you're going to click start. Now my Substrate is already in there. I have the suction on. That's why you're hearing that extra loud fan. It's keeping it down. And I'm going to click start. And it's going to begin printing. Now, this is going to take about 20 minutes. So I'm going to show you the beginning of the print. So what you're going to start seeing is the white going down first. So the way that the Epson UV printer works is it's going to put the entire layer of white first. So the color is not going to trail. So some printers will do white and then the second print head will pull color right behind, kind of as it goes. That's not how the Epson V1070 works. The entire white layer is going to be laid down first. Then the print head is going to reset and it's going to put the entire layer of color down. Then it's going to reset again and it will do the entire varnish layer. So the white is important here because it gives a base for the color to sit on. You don't have to print white on lighter color materials, but for something like this where it's not dark, it's certainly not like a walnut or anything like that, but I do think that it really helps the colors to pop. And just excuse the fact that this is the backside of this cutting board and it says that it was made, it's a Target, obviously Target cutting board. As I mentioned in previous videos, the front side I have previously lasered, and when you are a content creator, you tend to need a lot of examples, and so I use the front, the back, the inside, the outside of everything. So this design is from So Fancy. It's part of a bundle. I will link to that in the description below as well. But I love being able to do more than just cutting files with the SVGs and PNGs. So obviously you could use this for if you have a cutting machine or if you have a sublimation printer as well. But there's a lot of materials and substrates that you can't, you know, that you're not going to want to layer vinyl on, or you're not able to sublimate on. So that's where UV printing becomes a really awesome option. This is definitely an investment into your business, but it really is going to open up a lot of possibilities for you. So you can see that, like, you're able to offer these types of things that maybe your competitors are not able to, okay? So we're just learning this together. This is not my first UV printer, but it's certainly the one that I am using right now and liking the best, not only for the ease of use, but the software itself. I have held out on using Epson Edge Print for a long time because I don't need it for sublimation printing. I just use the drivers through my other software programs, but you do need Epson Edge Print to run the Epson UV V1070. Okay, so we're almost to the end of the white. I'm trying to get it so you guys can see. It's going to reset here shortly and pull back and then start doing the color. Now, I actually think it looks pretty nice just with the white, but. Okay, so here comes the print head again. It's going to reset. As I said, I may need to adjust the camera again. Okay, so the red or the color is going to go directly over the white. Now, There are a bunch of other settings in Epson Edge Print that I typically use or that I would suggest. I didn't want you to get in too much in the weeds with them. So if you are seeing a small bit of white bleeding out from underneath the color, there are options in there where you can basically choke back the white. And that's what I would suggest. I'll have other videos on that, but this is actually doing a pretty good job of covering the white completely. But there are many, many other options in there. We just did bare bones, super basic for, again, first print on the Epson V1070. Okay, the color is now done. So if you're keeping track, white layer first, then the color. Now it's going to reset and put down the varnish. And that purple light that you're seeing, that is the UV light. Okay, so it kind of cures as it goes along, and then it usually does another pass after putting the varnish down to cure again. Okay, so it's been about 15 minutes and our first print is done. So you saw all those layers that went down, and what we are going to do is now open this up, and this is now ready. So I'm gonna try to give it to you so that you can see. First of all, I need to turn off the suction instantly. Oh, you can hear a little bit better, I think. Okay, so I didn't do a perfect job of lining up, but that was pretty good as far as like just a rough guess. But let's see, can you see? Yes, you can see that nice shine on there. That is the varnish layer, the gloss varnish layer. Look at that. Okay, so beautiful. This is fully protected now. There's a little bit of a feel. I don't know if you're not going to be able to probably see it on there, but for a first project, this is a really good one. We just have a big substrate that is going to be pretty easy to print on. And of course, I'm not doing anything with this other than testing, which is why I'm okay with the fact that it probably needed to go over a little bit more. But we are going to work on alignment. I have a full video right here on a little trick of how you can line things up without creating your own jig.